See this man in action.
Okay, it is NWA World Heavyweight Champion Ric Flair in the ring now, and Flair objecting apparently about something in the center of the ring now, but now removing his robe. And there you see it around his waist, the $10,000 solid gold and diamond and studded belt representing the NWA World Heavyweight Championship. And my credit goes to Jones here, who is able to roll out of that guillotine. And that is a difficult task indeed. Anybody who can escape from that is certainly moving well. But there, Flair brings him up. Vertical suplex. And Jones in a lot of trouble now as Flair methodically comes down across his chest. And that's, of course, where he scored the initial impact, stunned his man with a spinning toehold right into the figure four, coming from the opposite side on the figure four. And it is Jones conceding very, very quickly.
And there you have it, the NWA World Heavyweight Champion Ric Flair in action. Before I talk to Tommy Rich and to Paul Orndorff, I want them to hear some comments from the World Heavyweight Champion Ric Flair. Here's a man who has been defending his title throughout the entire world, and here now are some comments from the champion.
For the king. But when it gets right down to it, there really only is one king. There only really is one man to sit atop that mountain all alone. Sit atop that mountain above all other professional sports. You know why? Because the man that wears the 10 pounds of gold did it all by himself. The National Wrestling Alliance World Heavyweight Championship, the most coveted trophy in all of sports, won by myself, no teammates, by myself, Ric Flair, the living legend, your champion, my belt, but your champion. And nobody will ever, ever take this away from me until I'm damn well ready to give it up. Believe that, because that's no brag, that's fact.
World champion Ric Flair, you know, something has dawned on me. You have signed a contract to meet the world heavyweight champion here in Georgia. You have signed a contract to meet the world heavyweight champion in Ohio. It could be that whichever one of you meets him first could end up as a world champion. That means that possibly you could be wrestling Tommy Rich for the title.
That's very true, Gordon. You know, it's quite an honor, anybody, you know, to get a chance to wrestle the world's heavyweight champion, to me, especially in the state of Georgia, because, you know, there's so many fans out there and everything. But if it boils down to where I beat him, and it would be meant that me and Tommy would have to wrestle each other and may the better man win.
Tommy?
Well, it's just like Paul said, you know, I was there one time. I've worked my way back up, and I want to wish Paul the best of luck in the world. And just like he said, you know, Ric Flair's been there, and if it come down that Paul beat him or that I beat him, it'd just be one heck of a contest, and I'd want the best man to walk out on top. And thank you very much, Gordon.
There you have it, Tommy Wildfire Rich and Paul Orndorff, top contenders for the World Heavyweight Championship. A lot of great matches, a lot of great excitement coming up during the next hour. Stay tuned. We'll be back in a moment.